Dysphagia is the word used to describe a swallowing disorder. So when someone eats and drinks, it can be really complicated. We use lots of muscles, intricately timed, firing in the right order, in order for food and liquid to get down from our mouth into our stomach. Interestingly, one of the most difficult things for people to swallow is liquids, and that's because they move quickly as they pass through the mouth and the throat. And so, one thing that we can do as speech language pathologists is we can choose to thicken the liquids to an appropriate level. There is a new method called the International Dysphagia Diet Standardization Initiative, or IDSI, which allows us to quantify how thick a liquid is very easily at home. We can teach patients and caregivers this measurement method. The challenge during the pandemic was that our students were getting great classroom education through our online delivery of content, but they're really craving the opportunity to interact with materials and patient-facing resources. So the first step in the project was having students identify items on drink menus at Panera, McDonald's, Starbucks. They then measured those drinks that they chose. We had a system using a Google spreadsheet. We had checks for reliability, so students measured each drink twice. A second student measured the same drink. And then we analyzed the trends.
I loved how fun and easy this project was. We were all in different places. We did it virtually. And it gave us the experience of having research under our belt. And the ramifications of this project is great for others. It's being able to have great quality of life, enjoying things you like without having to add thickener or just not enjoy a simple great drink. So I am really into research. I'm into acute care, which really includes a lot of dysphagia patients and patients with aphasia. And I really want to be able to see how I can get myself into more research. This is really one of my first steps into being a part of a research experiment. And I really was bitten by the bug to learn more.
So a project like this allows us to interface with the community. You know, there's opportunities to impact someone's day-to-day life. You could pick up a drink to share with your friend on your way to meeting them. But you know, it's ultimately about advocacy and awareness. And so hopefully this work done by these students will help bring that message to the forefront.